Alright guys, so as you've seen from my previous live stream, the old truck's not too happy. So, I'm going to do a time lapse, and I'm going to tear it all apart and see what went wrong. Hope you guys enjoy watching it, and we'll see what's wrong with this thing. Alright guys, so we got it out, making a mess everywhere, but we're going to rip this oil pan off here and see if we can see what happened down in the bottom. If not, then I'll have to pull the heads off of it, which I'm going to do anyway, but hopefully we'll find out it's in the bottom end. It'll be a lot cheaper. Alright, let's get at it. So, might have just found out what it was. I probably should have looked a little better before I pulled the motor out, but it did have low oil pressure, so we'll probably just go ahead and address that while we're here. But, check this out. I guess that's what a stock balancer would get you. A little bit too much RPMs. Okay.
first time I've killed a stock balancer, but I guess it's time to upgrade it.
Alright, so I guess we found our problem, but we'll go ahead and pull the oil pan off and check all the bearings and stuff. It kind of had about 10 PSI at idle, so I'm going to see if I can get that up a little bit. Maybe some new bearings. And I really wanted to do a 393 Strucker crank, but we'll just see what's in the budget. So I'm going to flip this around so we can pull this oil pan off here.
I believe it was that balancer though.
Man, them one piece oil pan gaskets are a trick.
In the fetal position.
I don't think we're going to see any carnage after finding the balancer. It just spun off the rubber, but everything looks pretty good as far as cleanliness. Or that guy. Still gonna just pull all these mains and rods off and just give them a good once over, and I guess if everything seems fine, we'll stick it back together. I might put a high volume oil pump in it just to kind of help with the oil pressure, see if it will help it anyway. But anyway, I'm gonna call it for tonight, and I'll be back out here tomorrow after I get off work to finish up.
2,000 years later.
Alright guys, so we're back to work on the 351 for the black truck. I'm waiting on some parts for it, but we've got a new Summit Racing balancer. If you're running same accessories as me, you need to put the clip on the very farthest one out and use both spacers. We got a new high volume oil pump for milling. Waiting on the rod bearings. You'll see it. It's still being the video. I'm not releasing it still. It's all done. But I'm going to show you how to check the oil pan, the oil pump, and pickup clearance. Get yourself some good old Play-Doh. Any color will work. As you can see, I got a gob right here on the oil pump already. I'm going to check the pickup.
Let's knock down first.
It recommends 25 to 28 on your oil pump bolts. I've already got these torqued, but I'm waiting on these until I get my rod bearings. grab you a big handful there. Don't give this back to your kids when you get done. I'm gonna get old all of them. Grab your old pan. Set her down on there. Try to keep it as straight as you can. Give her a good little push down. And hopefully they stay stuck to the pickup and the pump.
All good.
Let's take it back off here. You can see we're good on the pump side. We got, let's get the calipers out and measure that. All right, guys, we're back. About a week and a half later from the last clip. We got it all buttoned back up, getting ready to throw it back in the truck. Got those two rod bearings replaced and the new high volume oil pump in it. So let's get it back in the truck and maybe a couple days we'll get it fired up. This is, we went to the Summit branded balancer for this. On your flywheel bolts, make sure you use some thread sealant on. They will leak oil past them slowly, but they will. Alright, 75 to 85 foot-pounds on flywheel flex plate bolts on a small block forward. Always double check them. Just to be sure. Make sure you put your clutch disc the right way. Most of the time the
bevel part always goes towards the pressure plate. Alright, pressure plate bolts are 35 foot-pounds. I'm using grade 8 in mine with lock washers, 9/16 head. Alright, so next day, battery went dead on me. Trying to put the motor in, but we've got her all buttoned up. I think we're pretty much ready for the first fire up. Ain't got no coolant in it, just gonna try to start it. Always make sure you check for fuel leaks. That's good. We've got no ignition for some reason. I'm gonna try to figure it out. I'm with the wire for the distributor pickup. I believe I found the problem. All right, in the event that the 180 out, you just pull the distributor and pretty much if it's facing this way, you want it that way. Just turn it counterclockwise, big dummy. Vacuum leak. I remember that. Right here. back at y'all when I get some cooling in it and get her all kind of broke in. We'll take it for a little drive. And that should end off the video, so I'll catch y'all in just a minute. So we got it all back together. She's running as you've seen. I'm having some clutch problems. I tried to drive it down the road and it just slipped, so I turned right around. I'm probably gonna have to get that addressed before I can do a driving video on it, but she is back together. No more noise like it had from the balancer, but thought it might have been a rod. But we've got her back together and she's got decent oil pressure. I think hot, it's around 25, so that's better than 10. The crank in it's got some very loose clearances, so. But it is what it is. We're going to run it like it is, and we'll get this clutch figured out, and then you'll see it back in some videos. I'm going to try to do some upgrades to the rear end because it's still on leaf springs, and I'm not really liking it. I need some new U-bolts, stuff like that, so. But anyway, she's back together and running, so. That's what I've been trying to get it to. It has been, it's been a while. I know the video is pretty quick, but yeah, it's been out for a while. I'd say about 2 months. So in the process, I've rebuilt a Coyote and got a newer truck going. I sold the orange truck, unfortunately, but it's just right down the road. It ain't gone, but it's not mine no more. So, but Anyway, guys, I'm going to end it off here. I hope y'all enjoyed this time lapse. And give me a like and share if you want. But let me know in the comments if you actually do like this video and like the editing I've done on it. I finally got me a new computer so I can actually edit these videos smoothly. The laptop I was using was it was not good for editing good videos. So, but anyway, guys, I'll catch y'all on the next one. Thanks for watching. Oh yeah, I almost forgot. I wanted to show you guys this. I've had it before. I got rid of the orange truck, but I just hadn't really done nothing with it. This is a 1990 Sunbird Stinger with a 3.0 Mercruiser. Let me know if you guys want to see any videos on this, because I need to do seats and I need to do a lot of engine stuff, rewire it, because none of the electronic or the key switching stuff is working for it. And I also need to do all the exhaust bellows and the prop shaft bellows and all that good stuff. So let me know if you guys want to see that in any videos. So, all right, see y'all.